I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you dynamics of machine. In the dynamics of machine, I am focusing over the reciprocating masses. This is a very important problem and very different problem. In a four cylinder engine has two outer cranks are at 120 to each other and the reciprocating masses are 100 mm. The distance between the plane of rotation adjacent to the crank is 140, 750 mm. And 450 mm. The length of the crank they have given is 0.3. And length of the connecting rod. Crank is nothing but this is the crank part. This part we call as R. This connecting part we call as a connecting rod. This is L. This is your piston. The length is given L is equal to 1200 mm. It has to be converted to meter 1.2. The speed is given 240 rpm. Substituting the omega, you will get 25.13 radian per second. N dash will be R by L. 1.1 divided by 0.3 is 4. Now here the masses are given. Each masses. There are two outer crank. That is nothing but if I consider the link here, one in a vertical position, the outer is nothing but we have to consider 120 degree. That is fourth. There are four planes. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four strokes. Four planes. The fourth stroke occurs at a distance of, this is a multi-cylinder, okay, at 120 degree. We don't know about the angles of the second plane and third plane. We have to find out the angles of second and third. But they have given the masses 100 kg. That means I will consider this is a table, crank, mass, distance, theta and 2 theta. Masses, cranks are nothing but referring to the planes 1, 2, 3 and 4. Masses 100, we don't know M2 mass, we don't know M3 mass, but we know 100. Now what is distance? Now this is here, I am considering the reference planes as a second. Why I am considering this as a second? If I consider exactly at the center, it is not possible to measure it in a proper way. That means it will obtain a certain angle. Now, if I consider this one in a certain angle at the center, the diagram will be obtained in this way at certain angle from the horizontal line. We don't know this angle now. In order to avoid this one, we have to make any one plane to the zero. That is reference plane you have to make. Now, that's the way we are making the second plane 2 as a reference plane. Now, as it becomes the plane 2 as a reference plane, it becomes a reference plane. Then the angle for reference plane becomes zero. We can avoid the confusion of creating theta here. Directly, you can consider the reference plane. By using the reference plane, now here we have considered the one plane as a reference plane, 0. Compared to 1, we have taken as an angle 120. Okay. The reference plane is 2 here. This is 0 here. From 1 to this is we have to take negative and from this side you have to take positive. From 2 to 1, it is minus 0.450. 2 to 3, 0.750. 2 to 4, 1.20. What about the angle? Now, angle for this one is nothing but 0 here, 0, or you can consider this is a 0 angle. Here, we don't know. Theta 2, we don't know. We have to find out. Theta 3, we don't know. We have to find out. But we know theta 4, that is 120. Similarly, if this becomes 0, theta 2, we don't know, we have to find out, this is unknown for us, and 2, theta 3, this is unknown for us, 2 theta is 2 into 120 is nothing but 240. After completion of this one, Now here, this is the list of the formula, how to solve the problem. Now, because there are two unknowns here, therefore you have to start from the primary couple. It's the best to solve with the help of a primary couple. Don't go for the primary force here. First primary couple, then you can go for primary force. First, I'll consider the primary couple here. Primary couple. Primary couple I will consider. What is formula for primary couple? MV summation of M omega square R A cos theta. If couple comes, you have to measure, you have to take A in consideration. Now M omega square R omega square R summation M A cos theta, because M is also varying here. Now this can be written as what? Omega square R. What is M? As per the table, first one M is nothing but 100. A is nothing but this one into 0.450. Cos theta is nothing but 0. Next M2 into 0 into cos theta 2. Next M3 into 0.75 into cos theta 3 plus 100 into 1.20 into cos 120. This becomes 0 here. If you calculate omega square r, if you calculate this and this term, it will be, this term becomes minus 45, this becomes 0, plus M3, 0.750, cos theta 3, plus minus 60 is equal to 0. And this can be written as, now this is nothing but 0, this entire term becomes 0 here, only this term will be left, and this can be written as M3, 0.750 cos theta 3 is equal to 105. It becomes minus 105. You have to bring here, it becomes 105. This is equation 1. Similarly, you have to solve for PH. Summation of M omega square R A sin theta, you have to do it. Now in place of cos, you have to replace the sin term. Omega square R summation M A sin theta. Omega square R 100 into 0.45 into sin 0 plus M2 into 0 into sin theta 2. This becomes 0 plus M3 into 0.75 into sin theta 3 plus 100 into 1.20 into sin 120. If you solve this one, it becomes omega r omega r. Okay, I will write, solve directly here. I will write directly expression. M3 is equal to 0.750 sin theta 3 plus 0.3.92 is equal to 0. This becomes 0. M3 is equal to 0.750 sin theta 3 is equal to minus 0.103.92. Equation 2. Now, dividing 2 by 1, it becomes M3 into 0.750 sin theta 3 divided by M3 into 0.750 cos theta 3. This entire term will be cancelled, and this will be what? Minus 0.3.92 divided by 105. This become tan. tan theta 3? No. No, it lies in which quadrant here? It lies in which quadrant? This one lies in which quadrant you have to see? It's the rest of the formula. Minus plus, that should be my sign should be positive, the sign should be negative and cos will be positive. Now sine, this is the sine is negative, cos is positive. Therefore 360 minus 3 theta you have to do it. 360 minus theta. Now we'll bring the sine term here. Theta 3 is equal to tan inverse minus 0.3.92 divided by, don't use the minus sign while doing this one, just this indicate which quadrant it lies. Answer will be 0.98 or you can directly solve it, the answer will be 44.7038. Now because it lies in the fourth quadrant, therefore you have to do theta 3 is equal to 360 minus this theta, 44.7038. Therefore theta 3 will be 315.29 degree. It lies in fourth quadrant, therefore 360, because it is a now sine is negative, cos is positive, therefore you have to do 360 minus theta. Whatever value is operand here, you have to minus with help of 360. You will get the answer theta 3. Next, you have to find out the primary couple you have computed for vertical, you have to complete for the horizontal, or both are completed here. With the help of this one, we have got the theta 3. And substitute this theta 3 in equation 1, you will get m3. Put theta 3 in equation 1. Theta 3 in equation 1. You will get m3 is equal to 0.05 divided by 0.750 cos 135.29. M3 will be 194.65 kg. We got M3 is equal to 194.65 kg. Right here M3 is 194.65 kg or 63 kg. Next, after completion of this one, we got the theta also. Theta is nothing but 115.29 degree. Next, we have to find out the primary force. The formula for primary force, FPV is equal to m omega square r summation of cos theta. Omega square r m cos theta, you can write in this one. Refer the table here. Omega square r, what is m? So capital M, m is nothing but 100 cos 0 plus m2 cos theta 2 plus m3 is 194.65 cos 1315.29 plus 100 cos 120. If you measure the value, it will be m2 cos theta 2 plus 188.33 is equal to 0. Therefore m2 cos theta 2 is equal to minus 188.33. This is equation 3. Equation C. Similarly, PH m omega square r sine theta. Just replace, in place of cos, you have to replace sine. replace sine, it becomes omega square r bracket m sine theta. In place of sine, in place of cos, you have to replace sine here. Then m square r 100 sine 0 plus m2 sine theta 2 plus 194.65 sine 315.29 plus 100 sine 120. Now this becomes, so directly I will write here, m2 sine theta 2, I will bring this one here, it becomes positive 50.337, equation 4. From equation 4 divided by 3, it becomes m2 sine theta 2 divided by m2 cos theta 2. What is m2? 50.337 divided by minus 188.33. Now it lies in which quadrant? These two cancels. Theta 2 is equal to tan inverse. This value 50.337 divided by 188.33. Now it lies in which quadrant? See the here sine is positive. Sine is positive means this sine is positive and cos is negative. That means second quadrant. You have to take this in second quadrant. It becomes theta 2 is equal to 180. You can write in this one, tan inverse 50 plus 337 divided by 188.33. The answer for this one, 165.03 d. After getting here, substitute in 3 here, put in 3. You get m2 minus 188.33 divided by cos 165.03. The answer will be 194.94 kg. You will get. Now we got m2 is equal to 194.94 kg and theta 2 is nothing but 165.03. Now we can easily find out. Just you have to double this. Just you have to double it. This becomes 2 into 165.03 is nothing but 330.06. Similarly, 2 into 315.26 into this becomes 630.58. After knowing this one, you can find out the primary force and primary coupling. Now I'm finding the secondary force and secondary coupling. Now I'm finding the secondary force. Secondary force, this is the formula for secondary forces. Secondary force. FSV is equal to summation m omega square r n dash cos 2 theta 2 omega square r n dash summation m cos theta 2. Now how to solve this one? Refer the table. This is the table I am referring it. Omega square r n dash m is nothing but 100 cos 0 plus 194.94 cos this term 330.06 plus 194.65 cos 630.58 this term plus 100 into cos 240. For this one, the answer will be omega square r n dash 220.9. Similarly, FSH summation m omega square r n dash sine 2 theta omega square r divided by n dash m sine 2 theta. Now replace everything in terms of sign and you will obtain the answer omega square r n dash minus 37 minus 378.53. You have to replace in calculator the sign term, sign, you will get this answer. Now the final result, the resultant for this one is m ps for secondary force or you can write any rotation here, msv square plus msh square. I will bring this one outside, m square omega square r n dash root 220.89 square plus minus 378.53 square. What is the omega? Omega is here 25.13 square into 0.3 divided by 4 into 220.89 whole square plus minus 378.53 square. The answer for this one is minus, directly you can write it 20.758 kilonewton. I have converted into kilonewton. It will appear in this way. 2758 something, you have to divide by 1000, it appears in this way. 20.78 kilonewton. Now similarly, I will go for solving secondary couple. Formula MSV is equal to, MSV is equal to, this is the formula, summation M omega square r divided by n dash a cos theta, only a term enter into the, here a will be enter, omega square r n dash I will keep outside, summation m a sin 2 theta I will inside, omega square r n dash, what is m? From the table I have to refer here, m and a, in the table I will refer, this is the table, m and a I have to refer it here. M is nothing but 100, 100 into minus 0.450 into cos 0 plus 194.94 into 0 into cos 330.06 plus 194.65 into 0.750 into cos 630.58 plus 100 into 1.20 into cos 240. If you calculate, the answer for this one is omega square r n dash minus 103.522. Further, for the sine term m s horizontal, the summation m omega square r n dash a sin 2 theta, in the place of cos theta you have to replace sin term 2 theta, then it becomes final answer omega square r n dash, I'll write final answer for this one, minus 249.90. the resultant ms omega square r n dash root msv square plus msh square. Omega is nothing but 25.13 square into 0.3 divided by 4 root minus 0.3.522 square plus minus 249.90 whole square. Complete root. The MS final answer will be 1077.2.99 newton meter. It has to be written in kilometer, kilonewton meter, that means 0.72 kilonewton meter. I am Santosh Vaidankar Thank you very much.